Hello, I'm Sara Iepson of the Art Department at the Community College of Philadelphia, and welcome to Art History Abbreviated. By far, the most recognized icon in American history is the figure of George Washington. Everyone is familiar with the face of our first president that peers out at us from the warm, wrinkled dollar bills in our pockets. Most will recognize the stoic grand portraits painted by Gilbert Stuart in the late 1700s, depicting George Washington as a great statesman and leader. But far fewer are aware of the most controversial portrait of Washington created in the 19th century, which depicts our nation's first father in a larger-than-life-size guise of Jupiter. Sculpted by Horatio Greenough in 1840 to commemorate the centennial of Washington's birth, the image captured a completely new vision of our first president, one that was highly idealized and partially nude. Trained as an academic artist and fond of the art of antiquity and the Renaissance, it seemed logical to Greenough to think of Washington as one of the great ancient gods of Olympus. In his artistic studies, he saw numerous kings, emperors, and even popes appear in classical imagery in the guise of gods, or at least more perfect versions of themselves. Even the Emperor Augustus was often depicted as an idealized ruler, clearly deserving of and approaching godlike perfection. However, unlike the citizens of Rome, who understood and appreciated the vision of their ruler as nearing deified flawlessness, Americans responded with much less favor. The classical vocabulary that Greenough used in the work to evoke authority, power, control, and the persistence of the American political system first established under Washington was lost amid the many folds of our president's toga. With a body better suited to a warrior or youthful athlete, the sight of Washington's bare chest caused many to criticize Greenough's image. Perhaps Nathaniel Hawthorne best evoked the national response when he said, quote, "Did anybody ever see Washington naked? It is inconceivable. He had no nakedness, but I imagine was born with his clothes on and his hair powdered and made a stately bow on his first appearance in the world." Commissioned by the U.S. Congress for display in the U.S. Capitol Rotunda, Greenough's piece immediately fell under fire for being inappropriate, offensive, and even comical. It was said that the upward gesture of Washington's arm, intended to mimic the way that Jupiter pointed upward to his heavenly domain, was in fact a desperate attempt to reach for his missing clothes. Within a few years, the sculpture was moved to the Capitol lawn, later to the Patent Office, and finally to the Smithsonian Museum. Today, rather than being situated within the hallowed halls of the Smithsonian American Art Museum, the still controversial statue resides within the National Museum of American History, only steps away from sacred television artifacts like Archie Bunker's chair and Al Bundy's couch. Thanks for joining me today. See you next time on Art History Abbreviated. For more information about the Art Department, please contact us at the college.